In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the communion of the Holy Spirit, and the fellowship of God be with you all. In waters of baptism, Richard died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him in eternal glory. Let us pray. O God, to whom mercy and forgiveness belong, hear our prayers on behalf of your servant Richard, whom you have called out of this world because he put his hope and trust in you. Command that he be carried safely home to heaven, and come to enjoy your everlasting salvation. We make our prayers to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Please sit.
I invite Lenore to come forward to proclaim the reading from the book of Ecclesiastes.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. There is an appointed time for everything, and a time for every affair under the heavens, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to uproot the plant, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to tear down and a time to build, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn, and a time to dance, a time to scatter stones, and a time to gather them, a time to embrace, and a time to be far from embraces, a time to search, and a time to give up, a time to keep, and a time to throw away, a time to tear, and a time to mend, a time to be silent and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time of war and a time of peace. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. shepherd, so nothing shall I want. I rest in the meadows of faithfulness and love. I walk by the quiet waters of peace. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants,
forward to proclaim the reading from the second letter to Timothy.
A reading from the second letter of Paul to Timothy. My life has been poured out as a libation, and the time for my departure has come. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. From now on, there is reserved for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give to me on that day, and not only to me, but also to all who have longed for his appearing. The word of the Lord.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Do not let your heart be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I'm going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord. On behalf of the parish community of St. Vincent, I would like to extend my sincere condolences and sympathy to you, family, friends of Richard. I would like to assure you of our continual remembrance of him in our prayers, especially during our masses here at St. Vincent. One thing we do when we gathered as people of faith in our Catholic tradition, whether it is our big solemn Mass on Sunday, or whether it is ordinary Mass on ordinary week. So one thing we often do as Catholics is to remember our departed brothers and sisters who has gone before us. The priests always remember them at our masses. We remember them because we want to bring them before the Lord. We remember them because we want them, because many of them are in heaven, to pray for us who are still on the journey. We remember them because that is the only way we express our communion with them. We can't see them, but through prayers and sacrifice at our masses, we express our communion, we remember them. And in that assurance, I'm telling you that we also remember Richard in our masses and prayers. To you, family and friends, nieces, nephews, siblings of Richard, I know today that your heart is flooded with different types of emotions. Emotions sometimes that makes you people to feel so sadness, very, very sadness. Sadness that comes from the fact that Richard will not be longer present with you people. Sadness that comes from the fact that someone you love so much, had good and wonderful relationship with, you will really, really miss him. Although sadness, I really understand, because I myself, I have lost my loved one, especially my mother. All those emotions and feelings that will be going inside you people right now, all of them are normal and part of our grieving process. But we must have to remember, as Catholics, in our Catholic tradition, we believe in one thing, that like Richard, who lived this world as faithful follower of our Lord Jesus Christ, he is now with Jesus Christ. For him, life mainly changed, not ended. He is enjoying the presence of our Lord Jesus Christ. He is enjoying the presence of our Mother Mary. He is enjoying the presence of all his brothers and sisters who has gone before him. He is enjoying the presence where there is no more pains or sorrow. He is now praying for you and I, who are still on the pilgrimage, on the journey to meet him one day. More importantly, he is enjoying face to face, seeing God face to face. As your hearts are flooded with different types of emotion, Today's gospel reading I read gave us a very, very comforting words. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Have faith in God. Have faith also in me. In my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. I know we may be wondering. Many who don't believe in that there is heaven will be wondering, where will our brother be? Where will our uncle be? And also, he is in his Father's house, because there is many dwelling places. My dear brothers and sisters, yes, we are truly saddened from the passing away of our brother Richard. There is a way forward. Our way forward is to have faith in God. Many of us, our faith is so strong. We should help those who will carry this heavy load so down. We should help them to carry it with faith. We have to remember that our brother will not like us to keep crying, and wound ourselves. He will like us to pick ourselves and continue going. Sometimes, one thing I always tell people when they lose their loved one is, you will never, ever, ever forget Richard. To tell you that you will forget him, I'm lying. But how do we deal with it? Whenever you remember him, you allow his thoughts to flow through you. Some people, whenever they remember their loved ones, they will look for a nearby church and call the parish. Please pray for my brother, my sister, my friend. It's allowing the thoughts to flow through you. Pick up yourself. Try to pick up yourself and keep going. Many of us, it will take us days. Many of us, it will take us years. It took me 3 years to allow the thought of my mother to flow through me. I will tell you that many of you, it will take you years to allow the thought of your brother, your friend, to flow through you. But most important, have faith in God and allow the thought to flow through you. To us who are still alive, what will death remind us? Death reminds us of one thing anytime we come to funeral, that at the end, we will join Richard face to face. So we need to put God at the center of everything we are doing. I always tell my parish community, Blessed Sacrament, that God gave us everything in this world for us to enjoy, and we must have to enjoy them, but we should also put God at the center of our enjoyment, because at the end we will leave every wonderful things we are enjoying and behold God face to face and stay with him. No wonder in one occasion of the Bible, the scripture made it clear that heaven and earth will pass away, but my word will remain forever. A way of telling us that what matters is our friendship with our Lord Jesus Christ. Also, on one occasion of the Bible, the scripture encouraged you and I to seek first the kingdom of God, and every other thing will be added unto us. A way of putting God at the center of everything in our doing. Richard, from what I read, put God at the center of everything he was doing, because he knows very, very well that what matters, it is his friendship with our Lord Jesus Christ. And today, he is enjoying that friendship with our Lord Jesus Christ, with our Mother Mary, with his brothers and sisters, with his friends who has gone before us. So let us try, and every time, whenever this thought of Richard comes towards us, let us allow his thoughts to flow through us. As he continue to pray for us, we also will continue to pray for him. Please stand. My dear brothers and sisters, let us bring our prayers and petitions to God, that with full trust and confidence, He will answer us.
We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our beloved Richard. Strengthen our hope, so that we may live in the expectation of your son's coming. We pray to the Lord.
Amen.
In baptism, Richard received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead him over the waters of death to life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayer. The family and friends of Richard seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and give them peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Richard enjoyed spending time with his nieces and nephews. May those here present honor his memory by cherishing and being present to the people in their lives. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await us in the heavenly abode. Grant the deceased members of the Ruff family, including Fred and Frederick, and all the dead, an everlasting home with your son. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus Christ, we bring all these prayers and petitions on behalf of our brother Richard. We ask you to fulfill them according to your will. We make our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please sit.
I invite Peggy and Barbara to bring up the bread and wine for the Eucharist.
Thank you.
please stand. Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God Almighty Father. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Richard, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him, the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the sanctity of dying may be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, your servants, Richard, Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turned to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we proclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hand, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which we pour out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Edward, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Richard, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters, especially the family of Richard, who has gone before him in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of our Lord Jesus Christ, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always free from sin and save from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you say to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give to you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The peace and love of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you always. Amen. Let us wave to each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother Richard may come to eternal devil of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Please sit.
Glory.
Larry will now offer some thoughts about Richard.
We are here this morning to remember and celebrate the life of Richard Ruff, son, brother, uncle, and friend. Rich was born on June 7, 1964 in Pittsburgh. His birth led to some celebration, especially on my part, as he was the first boy after seven girls. He was the last sibling born in Pittsburgh before we moved to Albany. Being born in Pittsburgh led to a lifelong love of the Pittsburgh sports teams, especially the Steelers. Rich went to VI Elementary School and Albany High School. He worked for a while at Uptown News on Washington Avenue for his brother-in-law, Mike, and finally for New York State. I remember Rich having good stories about Uptown and more recently about the crazy things some New York State employees do in the parking facilities. Rich is part of a large family, including our mother, 10 siblings, many in-laws, nieces, nephews, grandnieces, and grandnephews. We are lucky to have such a large family. And everyone gets along and watches out for each other. Over the past year, his sisters, especially Lou, Lee, Maureen, Barbara, and Peggy, have shared looking out for him and helping him. Rich never owned any pets, but he was an animal lover and over the years helped watch some of the family's pets. His biggest pastime was watching sports. Excuse me. His TVs were larger than any I had ever owned. Being the oldest, I had hoped to never have to give the eulogy for any of my siblings, and being 10 years older than Rich has made it even tougher. But today, let us not be sad, but instead try to remember all the good things about Rich. Thank you all for coming.
Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother, Richard. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroy even death itself.
Thank you.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Richard in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestow upon Richard in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful God, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurance of faith, until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother Richard forever. We make our prayers through Christ our Lord. In peace, let us take our brother to his place of rest.
We will sing verses 2 and 5 of our closing.